Hey Beck, I'm just gonna light a few fireworks outside. Hey Beck, I'm just gonna light a few fireworks inside. Huh, what, where'd they go? Now what am I going to do? I know, I'm going to make my own fireworks using water, food coloring, and vegetable oil. Are you ready? Then let's get science. To do this experiment, you will need a jar, a plastic cup, a fork, water, vegetable oil, and food coloring. First, add water to the jar until it's 3/4 full. And put this to one side. Next, add some vegetable oil to a plastic cup to fill about this much. Then add about 4 drops of red, blue, green, and yellow food coloring. And stir this with a fork to break up the drops just a little bit. As soon as you finish stirring, pour it into the jar of water. Make sure you do this straight away. I got a little bit distracted the first time and left it for 10 minutes. It didn't work very well. But check this one out. Whoa, that is so cool. So what's happening? If we zoom up on a single water molecule, we can see that one end has a small negative charge and the other end has a small positive charge. The negative end is attracted to the positive end of another water molecule. This molecule's negative end is attracted to another one's positive end. All of these attractions hold the water molecules together. Oil doesn't have negative or positive ends like water, so isn't attracted to the water and forms its own layer. Because oil is less dense than water, it ends up floating on the top. And then something super cool happens. Food coloring is mostly water, so it starts to sink in the oil until it reaches the top of the water. When it reaches the top of the water, it dissolves and diffuses through the water. Check out my Skittles video to learn more about dissolving and diffusion. Whoa! Now it's time to experiment and to see what makes it look the most coolest. I'm going to change the temperature of the water, the type of oil, and the size of the jar. Let's see what temperature makes this look the most coolest. I've got 3 jars, one with water at 3.5 degrees, one with water at 25 degrees, and one with water at 50 degrees Celsius. The fireworks took about 20 seconds to appear in the warmest water, but because the water was warm, it quickly changed color. The fireworks took about 1 minute to appear in the middle jar. Most of the water stayed colorless for a long time, and I saw a heap of fireworks. The fireworks took 3 minutes to appear in the coldest water. But this jar had a heap of condensation on the outside that they were so hard to see. Of these 3, I think the water at 25 degrees is the best. Let's see what oil makes this look the most coolest. I've got 3 jars with water at 25 degrees Celsius. To this one, I've added the food coloring to baby oil. To this one, I've added the food coloring to vegetable oil. And to this one, I've added the food coloring to castor oil. The fireworks didn't work using baby oil. Baby oil has the lowest density out of the 3 and isn't very thick. The drops of food coloring fell to the bottom of the oil and joined together before I could add it to the water. We saw what it looked like to use the vegetable oil before. Remember, it took 1 minute for the fireworks to appear. Castor oil has the highest density out of the 3 oils. It's still less dense than water, so it floats on the top. Castor oil is also very thick, so the drops of food coloring took ages to fall, and the fireworks appeared after 7 minutes. Because waiting that long isn't super fun, I still think the vegetable oil is the best. Let's see what jar size makes this look the most coolest. I've got 3 jars with water at 25 degrees Celsius. This tiny one, this medium one,
and this large one.
I'm using food coloring in vegetable oil. The fireworks took about 1 minute to appear in all of these jars. There's something super cool about the tiny one, and it also used the least amount of each ingredient. For that reason, I think it's the best. Thanks for watching this episode of Silly Science with Simon. Let me know on Facebook or Instagram which fireworks you like the best, and I'll see you again in 2 weeks.